I represent millions of atheists and non-theists around the country, one of the fastest growing voter blocks. And you said earlier that you want to stand up for religious freedom and all of that. My question is, for atheist voters that are looking for somebody that will uphold their rights as Americans and not pander to a certain religious group, I just noticed your recent ad. It mentioned nothing about policy. It mentioned nothing about ideas. And it simply talked about wanting us to follow faith and find God and go to heaven and things like that, which is fine for those people that align with you. My question is, how do you plan on upholding our rights and focusing on non-theists? You know, because there's talks in our community about you running as pastor-in-chief instead of commander-in-chief. So I'm curious your thoughts.
Well, first of all, as I said during my speech, you have a right to believe whatever you want. You have a right to believe in nothing at all. You most certainly have that right. By the way, I'm a Christian. I can't force you to be a Christian. Christianity is a free gift. Mm-hmm. We Christians believe that salvation is a free gift that has to be willfully accepted. I can't force it on you. So you have a right to believe whatever you want, and I congratulate you on believing whatever you want. Right. And if you don't believe that Judeo-Christian values influenced America, you don't know history. This nation was founded on the principle that our rights come from our Creator. If there's no Creator, then where did your rights come from? We're also going to have a country where no one is forced to violate their conscience, which means no one's going to force you to believe in God, but no one's going to force me to stop talking about God.